根據政府最新公布的數字，其實香港人咧每日係抌緊136公噸嘅 PET 膠樽落堆填區嘅。咁以每個呢啲膠樽大概25 gram 嚟計啦，就係相等於超過500萬支膠樽裝飲品。
The consumption of electricity in the new college is approximately HK$100,000, and any amount of conservation of power will reduce the amount that we are paying to the electricity board. And this can be, these resources can be utilized for other purposes for the benefit of the residents.
以前我哋嘅時裝一年四季，但係而家已經去到一年52季啦。過去有一段好長嘅時間，全球嘅棉花嘅價格好唔穩定，加上歐美嘅國家對於本土嘅農夫咧進行補貼，造成生產過剩，令到好多嘅棉花咧反而傾銷去呢啲嘅落後國家，令到小農更加面對龐大嘅經濟壓力，甚至乎會貸款，有陣時被迫走上絕路，會吞農藥自殺。
我哋每一個人去改變自己嘅生活習慣，唔買膠樽裝飲品，唔用即棄嘅餐具。好像是一個小小的生活習慣的改善，但其實如果城市裏面700萬人都這樣做的話，就是一個很大的進步的。
Blue Sky is a Hong Kong startup. They have an equipment that has real-time monitoring of power consumption, and which was installed in 4 floors of the new college, which are being monitored on minute-to-minute basis. I would say this awareness needs to be carried much beyond the new college into the whole of HKU campus.
公平貿易正正就係提供一個合理嘅價格俾農夫，等佢哋有一個穩定嘅收入來源。由呢啲嘅小農組成嘅合作社，亦都會集體決定佢哋嘅社區發展金點樣用，點樣去建設佢哋嘅社區。由今日開始 ，be part of the solution， 一齊支持公平貿易嘅棉花，同埋好好珍惜手上面嘅每一件衫。Be part of it。
So HKU, reduce energy consumption and be a part of it。
從今日開始自備水樽。一齊源頭減廢 ，be part of it.
My name is Steve Cannon. I'm the Executive Vice President responsible, amongst other things, for campus infrastructure. University's made a major commitment for sustainability, but this is just the beginning. 2017 is when we really push forward. Be part of it.